The observable universe is 93 billion light years wide, and the unobservable stretches perhaps infinitely beyond what physics even allows us to comprehend. But right now, as humankind contemplates so-called long-distance space travel, just Mars can feel like it's impossibly far away, when really, in the grand scheme of space, there's so much more to consider than just the relatively tiny gap between us and our nearest neighbors. In fact, the sheer size and scale of space is one of the main reasons why scientists believe that there must be other life out there somewhere. And then, assuming that there is, what are the chances that none of it is more intelligent than we are? Not very high. Therefore, from some points of view, it's as though we're merely waiting to have the truth one day revealed to us by a more advanced group that we are not alone. Whether or not that will be a happy day or a disastrous one, though, depends on exactly what it is we encounter. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, could a Type 3 civilization invade the Milky Way?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
Nowadays, on the famed Kardashev Scale, Type 3 sits somewhere around the center, halfway between a civilization's lowly beginnings, Type 0, and its eventual ascendance to perfection, Type 5+. However, when Nikolai Kardashev first devised the scale in the mid-1960s, Type 3 was actually the highest original level. Types 4 and beyond have been added on only in the years since. At Type 3, then, a civilization has harnessed all the energy potential of its home galaxy. In our case, that would be the Milky Way. And naturally, it's no mean feat. The Milky Way is widely considered to be an average-sized spiral galaxy, but it still packs an estimated 100 billion stars, with almost all of them hosting at least one planet, probably more. And this vast cosmic structure itself stretches around 100,000 light-years across the universe. We've taken a closer look in past videos at exactly what it could mean to have all that energy at your disposal, so be sure to check those out next. But suffice to say, a Type 3 is an exceptionally strong, efficient, innovative, and smart society. It's evolved far, far beyond us 21st century human beings. In most iterations of Type 3, there's something of a hopeful outlook to what it might be able to achieve. Predictions tend to paint a positive impression of the world that it could create. And we've done it before on this channel, too. Limitless energy, which leads to a society where no one goes without. Optimized bodies so that we no longer need to suffer pain, feel sick, or even die. The abolishment of money to end inequality. The advent of beyond light-speed travel to beam us literally anywhere in existence. But alongside all of that hope, there are also various and mounting concerns. There are multiple ways in which a Type 3 might actually be not that great after all. First off, weapons and war. If you thought nuclear and hydrogen bombs were scary, then consider how primitive they would probably seem to a civilization with whole stars worth of power on tap. And indeed, a stellar bomb, however it's designed, wouldn't only be used to level cities, it could be launched to literally destroy worlds. Imagine what would happen were Earth to suddenly and forcibly be bathed in all the energy of our own star, the Sun. Nothing would survive a blistering, explosive, and fiery doom. Consider also that the Sun isn't even an especially large star in the Milky Way as a whole, and it's clear that star-powered weapons would be immense, terrifying, and essentially unbeatable. If it's an invasion you're after, though, perhaps you're less likely to just blast everything into non-existence from the outset. Maybe you would take a less heavy-handed approach to your intergalactic affairs. The unsettling truth about the Kardashev Scale is that if it is correct, then there should be Type 3 groups that are already out there. But the fact that so far we haven't been blown away by one arguably suggests that they don't all automatically crave death and destruction. So what's their game instead? Unfortunately, a stealthier, less noticeable Type 3 could be just as ill-meaning. While there's little doubt that our collective understanding of astronomy has vastly improved, and especially in recent decades, it's still the case that whenever we look deep into the sky above, we're typically left with more questions than answers. The twinkling abyss of the rest of the universe is still full of unknowns to us, including vast regions of high energy that are difficult to decipher, as well as apparent cold spots in the wider cosmos. More hypothetically, though, and despite all that we do know, would we ever realize if our telescopes were to pass over a hidden but watching Type 3 group? The James Webb Space Telescope is our best ever when it comes to unpicking the atmospheric details of far-off worlds. But even it still can't deliver certain proof of an alien presence. It can only highlight those planets that we should focus more intently on in the future. And regardless, from some perspectives, it could be that it remains inevitably held back anyway. The web is cutting edge for humanity, yes, but it's small fry to any hypothetically more advanced civilization that could be out there. In the timeline of a Type 3, it will have developed tools like the web probably millennia ago, and so it's a sure bet that it would be able to detect and evade it if it wanted to. According to some versions of Type 3, it's at this level that you can begin to move planets around too, and even stars, which could be beneficial were you ever trying to cloak yourself from view during an invasion. Although again, this degree of blatant interference might not necessarily be wise. Even humanity understands when a distant object's orbit is unusual. So it's likely that planetary rearrangement wouldn't go unchecked by, say, a low Type 2 civilization elsewhere in the cosmos. The Type 3, with all of its immeasurable power, wouldn't necessarily be threatened by any smaller and less advanced group that rumbled it. But again, if invasion is the order of the day, then an especially intelligent Type 3 would probably be less immediately obvious about it. What it might need, then, is some kind of secret route into its target galaxy. Some kind of hidden back door through which to sneak up on whatever it is it wants to conquer. Black holes are, for us, perhaps the most unknowable enigmatic structures in all of space. But to a Type 3, they're a definitive and flexible tool. By the time of Type 3, black holes have lost their fear factor and are now tapped into as well to harvest yet more energy. More than that, though, as they are capable of living in closer proximity to a singularity, and as they boast a complete knowledge of physics, including quantum, Type 3s potentially know what happens inside a black hole, too. Then, by either converting that knowledge or applying it to custom-built structures of their own, it's perhaps but a short step to fully functioning wormhole travel. And when it comes to invasion, this is probably the key technology. Bend wormholes to your every need, and you yourself could be safely lurking far out of sight, literally light years away, but you'd still have access to any unsuspecting lesser worlds, which ultimately is what human civilization is. But of course, all of this is wholly hypothetical. And even if we knew for a fact that there were Type 3 groups out there, the assumption that they'd be even a little bit interested in us specifically is probably laughable. That said, though, the Milky Way is another galaxy. And as any ambitious Type 3 steadily plots its route toward becoming a Type 4, it needs as many galaxies under its belt as possible. There's a supermassive black hole anchoring the Milky Way at its center, as there is in most other galaxies, and countless more dotted throughout our closest stars. So if there were a link to be found between them and wormholes, then we're essentially all living in a house with unlocked doors, waiting for the intruder to breach. Again, it's a little unsettling, but if we follow the Kardashev scale, then it's one possibly inescapable future outcome. What do you think could happen? Both if Type 3 exists at all, and if one of them ever set its sights on the Milky Way. Given the sheer size of the Milky Way, could we actually fail to notice that a takeover was even happening? And if so, could it be happening right now, at this very moment? It's certainly something to think about next time you're doing a spot of stargazing at night. Because that's how a Type 3 civilization could invade the Milky Way. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.